Okay, next up we have An Inconvenient Truth by Soya Aoyama. Please welcome Soya.
Hello everyone. Today I will give a presentation about evading ransomware protection in Windows 10. This is an inconvenient truth for Microsoft truly. I'll be happy to answer any question at the end of my talk. However, I'm not native, so go easy on me. First, let me introduce myself. I'm Soya Aoyama from Japan. I'm a security researcher at Fujitsu System Integration Laboratory Limited and organizer at B-Sides Tokyo. I've been working for Fujitsu more than 20 years as software developer of Windows. I wrote NS driver, Bluetooth profile, WinSock application, and more. I've started security research about 3 years ago. My first presentation was at AV Tokyo. It's one of the most famous security conferences in Japan. And the password is no drink, no hack. So I gave a presentation while drinking at that time. And I hope to enjoy drinking today too. All right, let's get started. May 12, 2017. Do you remember? Yes, it's the day of cyber attack by WannaCry. WannaCry caused tremendous damage all over the world. Ransomware, as represented by WannaCry, Microsoft gave one answer for it. It's literally ransomware protection. This is quoted from Microsoft Brown. Microsoft added the ransomware protection feature in Windows 10 for Creators Update as a countermeasure against ransomware. The new feature helps stop ransomware from accessing important files in real time, even if ransomware infected the computer. When the feature enables control folder access, lockdown folders, allowing only authorized apps to access files. I examine the ransomware protection in detail. This is ransomware protection screen in Windows Defender Security Center. When you turn on, there are displayed protected folders and allows a NAP through control folder access. We'll look at each item in detail. First, it's the protected folders. Set folder to protect here. Windows system folders are protected by detail, it's stated. This system folder is usually /c:\windows/system32. However, the folder is not included in this list. What is the truth? I show you in demonstration from now. This demonstration is two copy file to each folder, execute test program, and check the file. First, ransomware protection is disabled. You can see that the text file written "Hello World" was encrypted. Next, ransomware protection is enabled. Yeah, you can see that the text file was not encrypted, but the file in system folder was encrypted. The truth is Windows system folder was not protected by default. Do you know which folder that Microsoft calls the system folder? I don't know. Next, it allow an app through control folder access. Set applications access protected folder here. Apps determined by Microsoft as friendly is stated. What is as friendly? I show you in demonstration from now. This demonstration checks each application can make change to the file. First, I check apps of Windows 10. It's CMD. I did. I check password PowerShell tool. PowerShell is denied. you can see that some of apps in Microsoft are also allowed and those not allowed. Next, I check apps of other than Microsoft. It's 7-zip. Is very complicated. This version is allowed, but this version is denied. It seems depends on version. The truth is, Microsoft only knows. Do you understand what kind of mechanism it is? I really cannot understand this mechanism. Now, I found a vulnerability of ransomware protection. I show you in demonstration from now. This demonstration is encrypt the file with only patch file. You can see that the text file written "Hello World" is encrypted. Even if the ransomware protection feature is enabled, if you check Explorer with Process Explorer, the Explorer loads malicious DLL on the network. I'll explain how I injected it. Needless to say, it's registry. There is a shell extension list loaded by Explorer. It's under HKCR, asterisk, shell EX, and context menu handlers. This time, I use this GUID. The actual value of GUID is under here. It's shell32.dll. Even MSDN is written, HKCR is merging of HKLM and HKCU. And HKCU takes precedence from HKLM. It's the case of this GUID. There is a value in HKLM, but not in HKCU. So if you write the value to HKCU, you can change value of HKCR. This is whole mechanism. Normally, the value in HKLMM is reflected in HKCR. Explorer reads it and loads correct DLL. However, you can write a path of malicious DLL in the HKCU with user privilege. And its value is reflected in HKCR. Explorer reads it and loads malicious DLL. As a result, the malicious DLL loaded into Explorer can encrypt the user file. Of course, I submit vulnerability report to the Microsoft Security Research Center because I thought it very dangerous vulnerability and I want a little pocket money. However, MSRC's answer was, this does not meet the bar for security servicing. Unbelievable. How can we prevent this attack? Delete Explorer from friendly list. Fix to make Explorer load on this signed DLL. Both of these are Microsoft's work. What we can do it is to always check if malicious value are written in the registry. However, I think that this is not the fundamental solution. What is ransomware protection? The ransomware protection, feature that prevents file encryption, even if WannaCry has crossed the boundary using MS-17010. That is, there should be a new boundary here. Until now, account-based security boundary have been defined, and those that exceeded it are called security vulnerability. And now, boundaries that are not based on account was appear. We should reconsider definition of boundary and vulnerability. In case of not account-based security, I'd like to define security sub-boundaries and security sub-vulnerability. Okay, my presentation is over. If you want to see a demonstration of live, please catch me later. Thank you very much.